Sound guys, there you go. Thank you, sound guys. Well, everyone get rested up a little bit last night, hopefully. Ready for a big day today, amen. Cool. Well, we got the worship band. It's gonna, United Praise is gonna kick us off tonight. And, you know, we were even talking last night about the worship team. And, you know, it's amazing when you look through scripture, just the worship team was really an integral part to really living a life of God and serving God. Like, there was no, you couldn't live a life of God without a worship team. You know, I thought about Ezra when they were rebuilding, you know, the new temple. And Ezra, after they laid the foundation of the temple, it says he assembled all of the harp players and the lyres and the organs, and they actually worshiped and praised God. And I thought about that. I thought, can you imagine? We just poured the foundation of the church. Like, it's just a cement slab. All right, everybody, it's time to worship. Get everybody. Jim, get the band. You know, and they just worship God looking at this cement slab. And they give thanks and glory to God. And it's just a picture of the foundation, of course, in our life, it's Jesus Christ, which we should always worship and praise. But all the times they would worship, praise. Before they go out to battle, the worship team would fire up the band. We're going to battle. When they return from battle, let's fire up the band. We just came back from battle. Or maybe you find yourself like Saul, when he was chasing David, and David, fearing for his life, ran in the cave. And once God gave him his wake-up call, he said, Lord, I got my heart fixed on you. And he said, assemble the men. He said, we're going to sing praises to God forevermore. So wherever you find yourself, there's always a reason to worship, and you need a worship band to take you there. Because what really they do, church, for me anyway, is they prepare our heart. God's just after the heart. And I believe the worship team enables us to really just give the heart to God. Whatever that looks like, however that looks like, whatever that sounds like, it doesn't matter. We're just free to express and worship our God. And God recognizes the heart, man. The heart. So I thank God for the worship team, which truly is the heart of this conference. And I pray they enable you to just to worship your God this morning. And worship Him with freedom. Just to, you know, reach out and pray, get touched by God this morning. Amen. So,
amen.
Jim, in your capable, faithful hands, brother.
Thank you, brother.
Teach you a new one today. Play that intro again.
Right when the gavel fell, I heard the freedom that ring through the heart of Him. I'm going
Let's sing that again. Go on and speak.
Go on and speak against my borrowed innocence. The judge is my defense. I'm going free. Right when the gavel fell, I heard the freedom that ring through the heart of Him. I'm going free. I'm going free.
That second verse, I won't go back.
I won't go back again. That's just not who I am. Lord, I'm a brand new man. I'm going free.
Narrow road.
I'm on a narrow road.
Oh,
it's paved with days and hope. It's gonna lead me home. I'm going free. I'm going free.
Sing glory, glory.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. Through my shackles.
to sing this line a few times. Just let this build up in your heart today. Just worship the Lord. I'm free. I am free indeed. Singing scripture today.
I am free. I am free indeed.
Sing that again. I'm free.
I am free.
I am free. One more time, I am free.
I am free. I am free in thee. I am free.
I am free in thee. Now we sing, we are free. Our jailbreak. Amen. Praise God. I was buried my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb. Sing that again. I was buried.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you.
I was breathing.
Happened. When you call my name and I
head. The chains break at the weight of your glory. I need a shelter. I was an orphan. Now you call.
Let's sing that again.
Citizen of heaven. I needed rescue. My sin is heavy. The chains break at the weight of your glory. I need a shelter. I was an orphan. Now you call me a citizen.
When I was broken.
When I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. Just when you call my name, I ran out of that grave. I'm out of the darkness to your glorious day.
Praise the Lord. Brother Rich came up last night. He said, dude, you got to find a way to make that song longer, man. So we'll work on it. We'll try it again tomorrow and see if we can let Jerry unleash a little bit on that one.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet. Saved a wretch like me, yes, he did. I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Let's sing that again together. Amazing grace, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved.
Take a lead on that.
My chains are gone.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Wow. Just so good, God. So good, Lord. So good, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Linda's going to take us through a beautiful song, Touch the Sky. God's really blessed us with some amazing singers year after year. Just thank you for your gift, Linda. Mm-hmm.
deep, in oceans deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul rests in your embrace. For stronger in the presence of my Savior. oceans rise, my soul rests in your embrace. I am yours, and you are mine.
Amen. And that is such a beautiful song. Only God can take us to places we have never been. Amen. So thank you, worship team, for taking us some place we have never been. Give it up for the worship team. Well, you may be seated. You guys have wonderful shirts on today. Look, it's amazing. We all match. It's incredible. Well, praise God. Praise God. Well, we're in day two, team, and I'm excited because, you know, I get to introduce my brother. You know, it's the Porzio boys. Growing up, it was always the Porzio boys. And I thank God, actually, the tradition continues because I have two sons. My brother has a son. So the Porzio boys continue on. But, of course, I have a story from the Porzio boys as I introduce my brother. Probably not as eloquent as my brother's last night, but, hey, I'll give it a shot anyway. So this is probably about 25 years ago or so. I'm actually living here in Fort Myers on Jasper Avenue, and I was married at the time. And my wife then, we go out to some festival. I can't remember what the festival was, but we're in Fort Myers. And anyway, we were coming into the place, and this guy bumps into my wife. And of course, there's words. And so I put my wife behind me, and I soon find out I'm standing in front of four guys by myself, and I'm, you know, of course, I've got some bravado, but I'm thinking, I can count. there's more of them than there are me. So I was like, hokey dokey, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, this guy comes flying in. There's a problem here, Cupcake? It's my brother, Richard. I don't know where he came from. I never saw him. I thought he was like Clark Kent, like, boom. Like, I had no idea. And I never saw his face because he literally got in front of me and the other gentleman that I was speaking with. So he literally jumped like right in front of me. I didn't see his face, but what I did see was the other gentleman's face. And guess what? He was scared. So we, you know, nobody was harmed during the filming of that scene, everybody. But my brother steps back, you know, things, you know, everybody kind of goes their ways. And then, as only my brother can do in his most eloquent fashion, blows this guy a kiss. And I see the guy look, but he just turned his head and walked away. And, you know, that's what my brother Mike was basically expressing last night. You know, we do call him the Lionheart. And that's because my brother's fearless. And it's not that he's reckless. No, he's fearless. My brother's not reckless. He is fearless. And I thought, Rich, I couldn't help but think of another account. And again, this was probably 20 years ago, maybe 25 years ago. But anyway, my brother had this dream. He pursued it, and God bless him. He finally got his pilot's license. And I remember he calls me up. He's like, hey, you want to go up? I'm like, what do you mean? Well, I got my license and everything. I'm like, okay, but you got a plane? Yeah, I got a plane. And I'm thinking to myself, my little brother's got a plane? Yeah, I got a plane. I'm like, okay, so I meet him up at Page Field. True story. I meet him up at Page Field, and sure enough, you know, he brings me in the lot there, and we're walking towards this plane. And I'm, again, listen, we grew up in the city, guys. The fact that my brother had a pilot's license and a plane, and we were going to go up in the sky, like, there was nothing more further from reality as far as I was concerned. But anyway, I'm standing there, and we're, you know, he's doing like a check, I guess. I don't know, you know, I guess doing like a pre-trip, walking around the plane, and you know, I'm like, okay, and sure enough, we get into this plane, little Cessna, I guess, Rich, right? And I realize I'm sitting in this plane, and now reality sets in. I'm like, my little brother's taking me up thousands of feet in the air. I don't know if he's qualified to do this or not, because like, I'm just looking at childhood thinking, he can't possibly fly this thing, can he? But sure enough, folks, we're taxiing. My heart is in my throat. And Rich is just You would have thought he was, I'm sure he was only flying for a couple of months. You would have thought he was flying for 30 years. Yeah, back in WW2, you know. Yeah, me and the fellas, we had a couple of runs, you know. Fearless. And I'm scared the entire flight. The entire flight. Anyway, we go up, and we'll go to Punta Gorda. I'm like, okay, cool. So we're getting towards Punta Gorda. He goes, I think it was a touch and go. We're going to do a touch and go. Like, I know in what in the world he's talking about. And again, church, I'm like just clutching the chair. Okay, touch and go. Well, sure enough, I didn't know what he meant. So he's clearing with the tower, bada bing, bada boom. Well, sure enough, a touch and go is just that. You hit the ground, hit the runway, and then you bounce right back up. But he didn't tell the tower that. They thought he was landing. So we do this touch and go. He hits, and then is it the throttle? The throttle, church. He's laughing. Now we're just screaming up towards the sky. I'm thinking like, oh my God, we're gonna die for sure. Now, there's so much fear in me, I didn't wanna let go of the seat, but I wanted to turn over and punch him because I'm like, what are you doing? It was like Top Gun, you know, remember with Tom Cruise? Permission to buzz the tower? Permission denied, the pattern is full. Richie said, buzzing the tower, man. I didn't know if we were violating the airspace, they were gonna come out and shoot us down. I don't know what's going on. But my brother was just all I saw was nothing but pure joy in his eyes. He wasn't scared, we just did this touch and go, man. And so my brother, because he is fearless, takes me places that I can't go. And I pray this morning, brother, you take us places that we can't go because he is fearless. So just like in Top Gun, I will be your wingman. Ladies and gentlemen, the Maverick, my brother, Richard Porzio.
Thanks. Well, that was awesome. Is anybody ready to party? If free people party, that's what we're here for. Amen. That was a great intro. Thank you very much. It's such a great honor to be here. The title of my message this morning got me a little teared up. I'm sorry. Hold on, time out. Let me start this out right. The title of this message this morning is Shackle Breaker. Shackle Breakers. Anybody need some shackles broken off? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. The title of this message is Shackle Breaker. That is not just the title of this message. That's the intention of this message. That's the purpose of this message. That's the effect of this message of talking about the powerful Word of God. The intent of this is going to break some shackles.